Hey everyone, welcome back to Nintendo Prime. This is a bit of a different video because I haven't done a channel update in a long time. In fact, based on my ability to search my channel on the back end, I haven't done one since 2018. I feel like there's probably been some in between that I just didn't call channel updates, but really there hasn't been an official update since then. There's been announcements of plans that never came through, but things are a lot different today. I'm a lot more organized, and the channel is a lot more consistent. So because of that, I want to be sure to address some things here that are happening. Some things have already happened at the channel. Some things are going to be happening in the future. Give you guys an idea of where this channel's going, address some complaints, address some questions you guys had, and yeah, we'll go from there. So first off, the very first thing is something we did talk about in yesterday's video, although a lot of you might not have got to it or skipped that section because it wasn't something you cared about because it wasn't really new, like gaming news. Our podcast is moving. So the Nintendo Prime podcast now has its own YouTube channel. So I want to clarify what this YouTube channel is for. It is not to put the podcast up after the fact and throw clips up, although we will have clips there. We're actually going to host the entire podcast on that channel. So when we live stream our podcast on Wednesdays at 8 p.m. Central Time, we're going to be live streaming them on that channel. Now, we're not moving the podcast over there right away. Like, I don't think we will be live streaming there this upcoming Wednesday. We are not going to be streaming there until we have all of YouTube's features unlocked on that channel. So for now, I am just uploading old episodes there, and I will upload any episode we do in the future on this channel there. So it's going to feel like we're not using it for that, but we plan to use it for that. We just need to hit 1,000 subscribers on that channel to unlock it. Right now we're like 265 subscribers or something like that over there, which is incredible considering that I barely even mentioned it exists. So go over and subscribe to that channel. There'll be a link in the pinned comment and down in the description as well to do that. Again, we want to try to get that up to 1,000 subscribers so we can unlock all of YouTube streaming features specifically. That way, I can bring you guys the same quality of cast over there, if not better, than I do at this channel. Also, if you really enjoyed the Nintendo Prime podcast in the past, you're going to want to subscribe there and set your bell notification there so you actually get notified. Since the only thing going up on that channel is podcast-related content, be it the full podcast or clips from the podcast, if you really enjoy the podcast, you don't want to miss it, make sure you're over there. For now, I think it's still going to be here, maybe through the end of this month. I'm hoping by December to fully move everything over there if we can hit that 1,000 plus subscriber goal. It'd be great if we got to 2,000, 3,000, 5,000, 10,000. It'd be really great, but let's see what happens. Now, some updates specifically for this channel beyond the fact that we're going to be moving the podcast away. I have now gone through and unlisted and or privated a vast majority of the playlists on this channel. We had over 70 playlists, and frankly, most of them aren't that relevant. A lot of them lost all their viewership after we got hacked. Yes, folks, for those who aren't aware, we got hacked right at the end of October, close to Halloween. My YouTube channel's name changed to like Sheena Ibu or something like that, and there was a big crypto stream, and technically I still could see the crypto stream on the back end. You guys can't anymore. I'm the only person that can view it. It sucks. But the interesting thing here, obviously, is that a lot of this old content really lost all its ability to give views. We had old video game walkthroughs for like the Wind Waker HD, Spirit Tracks, and stuff like that. And unfortunately, because of the hacker, they ruined all of the SEO on those videos, and they pretty much don't have any views anymore. So we have gone ahead and essentially privatized and or unlisted. Now, all the videos are still on the channel, and you can still dig through the channel and find them. I'm not deleting videos, but we are getting rid of the playlist to make it a bit easier to find the content that I guess matters today. That being said, we now have 4 playlists, and one of them might be going away or getting shuffled a bit. One of them is gaming news. So we have renamed the Nintendo News playlist to gaming news. So if you already follow that playlist, just know that nothing's changing there. I just decided to do away with, because I used to have a Nintendo News playlist, an Xbox News playlist, and a PlayStation News. I decided we're just going to make it general gaming news playlist. Now, it's primarily going to be Nintendo News anyways, but anytime I do cover a news story for, say, Xbox, PlayStation, PC, etc., we're just going to throw it into that specific category, because that category is literally a news category playlist. So it just makes sense to leave it there instead of, you know, trying to confuse people with playlists that don't get updated as often, because obviously we don't cover PlayStation and Xbox news enough, I think, to really maintain its own playlist like that. If that changes in the future, we'll see, but I if anything, I would probably spin off channels. If I'm going to start covering hardcore PlayStation news daily, that's going to be like its own channel, right? Beyond that, the other one we have is basically it's Nintendo discussions being rebranded to gaming discussions, because this is where I'll put my rants. This is where I'll put any discussion videos or any, like, if I do like a top 10 video, which again, I don't do those kind of videos very often, but if I do like a top 10 or a top 3 or a wish list, or, you know, some random video where I order a bunch of items off Wish for Switch, and then like kind of make a fun video out of that, all that's going to be in that category. So it's kind of like the other category on the channel where I sort of stuff most everything else. The third category that's still there right now is the Nintendo Prime Podcast, since it's not fully moved to that channel until we get our subscriber count up there. We still have the podcast category right here. And then our fourth one is actually one that you guys might not even be aware we have. There is a Zelda documentary playlist on the channel. This documentary is actually an official Nintendo documentary they only ever released in limited quantities on VHS, I think back in the late 90s. And as far as I'm aware, that we are the only place on the internet right now to find that documentary. It's in multiple parts. It's been translated. The captioning isn't like the greatest in terms of trying to read it, but it is there. It's in English. So good luck if you guys want to go check that out. Literally, it's a Nintendo made one that has been lost to time. In fact, you'll see at the beginning of each video, you'll see the words Zentendo. They're the ones that actually had the original VHS and transcribed it and put it on the internet. That website no longer exists. And when they were going to go out of existence, I talked to the owner and founder of the website that actually owns the documentary and got his permission to re-upload it at our channel so it wouldn't be lost to time. So yes, we're going to leave that playlist up as well, because that, to me, I'm a big Zelda guy, and this is a piece of Zelda history that literally you can't find anywhere else. So that's really cool that we can say that about our channel, that we have something that nobody else has. This predates Hyrule Historia. It goes over timeline stuff that's crazy and totally contradicted today. It's a lot of fun if you guys haven't watched it. But again, it's an old school video. All right. Moving on, we have schedules. And any of our longtime viewers know how well I do with schedules. But I think they can also admit that I've been very consistent at the channel for a while in terms of I basically get up a video a day, at least. Sometimes multiple, but typically at least a video a day, except on weekends when I don't promise I'm going to get videos out on weekends. I would like to get videos out on weekends, but that's also me, family time, school time, etc. So weekend videos are not guaranteed. But Monday through Friday, I've been very consistent at getting a video out. So I want to up my consistency with that by having a little bit of a schedule. And what I mean by that is I'm aiming to have my daily news content. These are the videos that contain multiple news stories. You guys know them. You guys love them. I'm planning to have that video out by 11 a.m. Central Time on Monday through Friday. So that would be noon Eastern time or 9 a.m. Pacific time. I don't know if you're outside of those time zones. I'm not sure what time it is for you. You'll have to do the conversion yourself. But I'm aiming to have it open to them, because I've obviously noticed when I release videos anywhere from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., they tend to perform better because they get a better start, because a huge chunk of my audience appears to be on YouTube around that time, which isn't shocking because those are like lunch hours. If you have a job as an adult, like most of our audience is actually adults that are working. So yeah, it actually fits right in where, oh yeah, I want to check out this video on my lunch break while I'm eating, you know, pop in the headphones and kind of listen to today's news while you enjoy your lunch. So we're going to try to aim to have that. I don't want to say it's exactly going to come out at 11 a.m., but we're really hoping to. Obviously, there can be times when the video is extra long. Like we had a 27-minute one earlier this week, and maybe the render time on it due to all the various edits in it might be a bit longer and cause some delays. But in general, I'm pretty confident about this, because essentially what this means is I get up, get my children off to school, at least right now during the school year, obviously different during the summer. And then I get to spend, you know, pretty much the next 4 hours putting the video together and getting it out to you guys. And that's something I'm willing to dedicate to you guys every single day. That's like my 4 hours Monday through Friday that I'm going to give you guys on this channel to try to make that consistent. And then I have to do my other work stuff and school and all of that. Now, there's another thing we do on this channel, and this is streams. We do streams 2 days a week. I'm actually going to increase this to every Monday, Tuesday, and Friday. Now, this doesn't count the podcast stream, but again, that would happen on a very different channel. You know, we'll advertise it on this channel, but it's going to be on that podcast channel full time. So this stream schedule is based around this channel and the notifications this channel sends out. So I'm looking to do live streams at this point every Monday, Tuesday, and Friday from 8 p.m. Central Time until whenever. Some of them will be shorter, like say some will be an hour or 2 hours. Others will be longer, like say 3 hours, 4 hours sometimes. So I can't guarantee how long each stream is. It's going to depend on my time, but I will guarantee you'll get at least an hour long stream on those days. What will we be doing on those streams? Well, a lot of it's going to be the same thing we do now, two of the streams. Right now, it's looking like probably every Monday and Friday. Those two streams are going to be kind of standard streams that we do. So where we bring up some news topics, we do some Q&A, and we have some fun and have some drinks and all that. We're going to keep that kind of going. I really enjoy that kind of stream. Tuesday's live stream is going to be a little different. I'm aiming for Tuesday to be our game night of the week. So we're going to be doing some game streaming on Tuesdays, probably of Nintendo Switch, of course. And yeah, it's going to be whatever I kind of feel like playing that day. If it's a multiplayer game like Splatoon 2 or Mario Kart or I don't know, Super Mario Party, Superstars or whatever. The thing is, anybody who wants to play multiplayer matches with me needs to be a member of our YouTube channel by hitting the join button. You know, that's how you become a member of the board of directors here, or you need to join us at patreon.com/NintendoPrime. If you are at one of those two spots and a backer at one of those two spots, you can get my friend code and our Discord server, which will also be linked below. We have some private channels for the members, and they can get my Discord, they can get my Switch code there, friend code, and then we can hook up for some multiplayer matches. And I will try to let members know ahead of time if we're going to be doing a certain game on that night, so they can know if they can be around or if they have the game, etc. Now, the chat's still going to be open to the public, and all you guys are still going to be able to chat with me and watch me play. And sometimes I'll be playing single-player games as well, so it's not always going to be multiplayer games. But this just gives a chance to get back into some gaming at the channel. You notice we haven't done a lot of gameplay clips or reviews or anything like this, so this just gives everyone a reminder that I do play games, so let's actually play games and be kind of a community on Tuesdays. All right. In addition to this, we do launch streams for games that I'm really interested in or that will be a big deal on Switch. As an example, for Breath of the Wild 2, not only will we be streaming, the Friday it comes out, I guarantee we'll be streaming all weekend long, probably 8 hour plus live streams. It's going to be insane. That's just something that I do for things that, you guys might remember my old Breath of the Wild ones in 2017. It's just something I do that's extra and special and on top of what we already do. I can't guarantee which games, but I'll try to announce ahead of time in the community tab if there's going to be specific games that I will be doing launch streams for, which are in addition to our normal streams, or sometimes we'll take over a Friday stream instead. We'll see. The game stream also, by the way, if by popular consensus people wanted to move to a different day, we could see. I know some people are going to say streaming on Saturdays. Again, I'm keeping my weekends open for my family. All right. Beyond all of that, I want to remind you of any current community events. And basically the current community event we have upcoming is Prime Giving. It happens on November 28th at 8:30 p.m. Central Time. Might start early at 8, although we probably won't give anything away till 8:30 since that's the current scheduled time. That's the event where we're giving away the Switch OLED bundle. We got some other prizes involved on this. Potentially a Pokemon Switch Lite could be one of those other prizes, so don't want to promise that quite yet, but we got some stuff going on behind the scenes. Setting that thing aside, we also have a $100 charity donation. The next community event after that is going to be on December 9th. We'll get that stream set up here in a bit as well, once we have finalized times for it, which I think we're going to get soon, for the Game Awards. So we're going to do an hour pre-show before their pre-show, and then we'll cover their pre-show and cover the event, and then do, I don't know if we'll do a full hour after the event, but we'll see. That's going to be another fun event. Both of those events will involve Eric at this time. So you guys, if you liked our stuff that we did during E3, kind of look forward to another thing like that. Remember, people loved what we did during E3, and we're going to try to roll it back again here and have a good time. So I'm trying to make the Prime Gaming event fun. It's going to be, obviously, you know, we'll take questions and we'll talk video game news, but we might have some gaming competitions in there and, you know, little stuff like that, that, you know, maybe some a quick game of Smash, quick Splatoon 2, you know, something we, the stuff we try to do during E3, except actually have it work this time. Yeah, so look forward to that, because I am going to be working really hard to make sure we don't have any streaming issues with our Switch this time around. I have a solution in-house that I think is going to at least get us by for now. So yeah, that's kind of what we have for the next upcoming events. So another thing I wanted to address now is how the channel is done post-hacking. So I mentioned we got hacked by crypto people at the end of November, or at the end of October. And I can say viewership-wise, we're actually doing quite wonderfully. We did have a lull for a few days, but after talking to a lot of people in the community, both through the community tab and our Discord server on Twitter, the community outpouring towards my channel to help it get back on track has been absolutely incredible. Our viewership is actually right back to where it was before the hacking, which is just amazing, since before the hacking, we were still getting viewership bumps from Switch OLED. So to still have that kind of viewership bump now is incredible. But what's cool about the viewership bump, or I should say, what's basically become our standard viewership, which is 4,000 to 8,000 views a video, sometimes 10,000, is that 70% of every video we have posted since the hacking, the viewership numbers have been from subscribers. 70%. Before the hacking, it was around 30 to 35% of our viewers on every video were subscribers. So that means that if our viewership didn't dip, but more of our subscribers are watching the videos now, it means the community is showing up big to support the channel and keep the videos at a high volume of views. And I really, really appreciate that. It also means that if we're at that same, you know, number of views as before the hacking, but more from subscribers and less from new viewers, it also means our growth is a little stunted at the moment. It means that YouTube's AI system is not yet suggesting our videos to new viewers at the same rate it was before the hacking. And from what I have talked to our MCN and talked to some people at YouTube, it's just going to take a while for the AI algorithm to pick us back up again. So thank you so much for keeping my, you know, keeping my sanity a little bit by keeping our viewership up and really supporting the channel in that way. You know, I literally can't thank you guys enough for it. I'm absolutely moved at how much the community has stepped up for our channel. Please keep it going moving forward, because why not? I hope you're enjoying the content. That's the big thing. I don't want you just doing it to help me out. Do it because you actually want to. To give you an idea of like how we haven't fully recovered yet, we were gaining 2,000 to 3,000 new subs per month for the last like 3 months. But unfortunately, due to the hacking, our last 30 days has now sunk to only 128 new subs because of how many we lost due to the hacking. And there's not really a whole lot we can do about that. We just have to keep pressing forward with our videos, not getting suggested to new viewers at the moment. It's really hard to gain growth, but we are seeing a little bit of smidge of growth the last couple of days. Hopefully we can just keep sustaining that, and eventually YouTube should turn around for us, we hope. Anyways, no guarantees, we don't control YouTube. Those worried about us losing revenue, well, we did have a lull for a week. We're now back to our typical advertising tier on YouTube. At least that's what it feels like, although this could just be due to the holidays, because everyone gets bumped up a tier during the holidays anyways. But I think this is going to sustain, at least partially sustain, you know, after the holidays. All big YouTubers know, yeah, your money still goes down after the holidays, but you can still maintain a certain level. So we'll see what happens in January. Will be a really telling month. So some people want to know what you can do to help if you want to get us back on our growth path that we were on. Just do mostly what you already do, like the videos. Watch the videos and, you know, try to watch them all the way to the end, unless you don't want to, of course. You know, share our videos with your friends and family and comment on them, you know, things that we already try to push for people to do anyway. So you guys are already doing it, so just keep it up. So Bacon Pancakes, I'm just using him from our last video, but some other people brought this up as well, including on our Discord server, says, what's with all of the Breath of the Wild clickbait? Stop luring me back here if you don't have any news of the game that's in your thumbnail, or I'm unsubbing for real. Well, for starters, I'm sorry, Bacon Pancakes, to probably lose your subscription at some point. The thing is, I don't like having to use what you would call clickbait. I don't like it. I would rather just make whatever thumbnail I think looks the best to match the news and make the headlines really boring and straightforward. Why? Because it makes my job a lot easier. I don't have to think. It's what's the news? Put the exact news in the headline, put the exact imagery from that news in the thumbnail and call it a day. You know how much less work that would be for me? How simple that would be for me? The problem is when I do that, people don't watch. Now, I don't know if this is just an algorithm related thing or if it's because maybe I guess the news isn't that exciting in the first place. I don't know. I try to only pick stories that I think are important. So when I use like a term in a thumbnail like big news, I mean that because I think all the news I cover is a big deal. If it wasn't, we wouldn't be covering it. Obviously, I recognize there are some stories that people consider to be bigger deals, like, oh, news on Switch Pro, news on Breath of the Wild 2. That feels like bigger deals to some people. While to others, those might not be big stories. I can't help what your subjective opinion is on that. But what I will say is the biggest and hardest thing to do on YouTube is get attention or get new viewership through the door. My biggest goal with my videos is first and foremost to provide a quality video. And I think if you sit through my videos and you watch them, I think you can agree the editing is pretty okay, at least. You know, my set is obviously different than pretty much anything else on YouTube. So I think that adds an air of difference and professionalism. Obviously, I use a lav mic as well. Not everybody uses lav mics. And I also just want people to think that I put together a good quality production and can be entertaining when it calls for it. Again, I don't script my videos, including this one. So the thing is, that's my chief goal. But my second goal is to get new eyeballs in to grow the channel, because I obviously have a dream, like pretty much any content creator probably does, to sit down and be able to quit any other jobs I'm doing and just do this because I enjoy it. Everyone would love to do something they enjoy for a living. That might never happen here at YouTube, and that's okay if it doesn't, but I'll be darned if I'm not gonna try to make it happen. And the first thing you gotta do is get new people to view your channel, and then you hope whatever I present, be it the giveaways, be it the actual news, be it my personality, be it the presentation style, or whatever, that people end up, you know, watching a video or watching me as a content creator that they might not have otherwise watched, and then subscribe. I mean, that's really the goal, right? To grow a channel. And to do that, you gotta get new people through the door. Now, clickbait, unfortunately, is something that does work really, really well on all social media platforms, be it TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, or whatever the hell other networks people are using. Clickbait just works. So I don't like to do like a bait and switch Breath of the Wild 2. Like in this case, you're specifically probably complaining about the thumbnail in yesterday's video where it had the Zelda 35th anniversary and there was like a Breath of the Wild 2 fan art along with like the Wind Waker HD or something like that. And I could see how that might be annoying because maybe it made people think, oh, there's going to be a trilogy. Honestly, it was a pre-made image I got off Google Images. I was just trying to get the 35th anniversary logo, like a clean fan logo of it, and I couldn't find a clean one that wasn't already, you know, thrown onto other imagery. So I ended up just using imagery that already existed. It really wasn't an intentional clickbait in that sense. I just wanted the logo and, well, the rest of the imagery just kind of came with it. So I do apologize for that part. I really wasn't trying to tease Breath of the Wild 2 stuff. That was not my intent. But there was Zelda 35th news in the video. It just wasn't that exciting of news. And maybe the thumbnail and the title makes it sound like it's more exciting than it is. But that's kind of sort of what clickbait is in a way. It's not necessarily always lying to you. It's just getting you through the door and then you decide from there. So the biggest thing for me as a channel is just to get people in. Once they're in, if they get disappointed by the title, okay. And you might go, Nate, that hurts the channel. You're hurting the channel by doing this. People like Bacon Pancakes are gonna unsubscribe. And that's fine. You also likely want to follow my channel and subscribed in the first place if it wasn't for these kind of videos. That's just the unfortunate truth of the matter. Plus, if you're unsubscribing, I'm sure you know, people will be happy because it's just one less person trying to win our giveaways. But that's neither here nor there. If you want to unsubscribe from the channel, unsubscribe. I always tell people, if my content isn't for you, it's not for you. But I got to worry about growth, and I got to play the YouTube game. And the YouTube game is get people in the door and then hope you win them over with your content. If you don't get people through the door, you don't. So when I don't do that kind of stuff, I barely get any views and we don't grow. In fact, the last few videos that I didn't clickbait at all, didn't do anything. It was just direct, here's the news in the title, here's the news in the thumbnail. All of them got less than 4,000 views, and they only got like 5% of views from suggested, which tells me, yep, people don't care. The click-through rates were horrendous. It just wasn't good. And I ended up losing an average of 30 subscribers per video that I did that. Whereas the last two videos I did that admittedly were a bit more baity in trying to get people to click, I gained over 100 subscribers between those two videos. So you kind of see the conundrum. It works. If it didn't work, we wouldn't be doing it. I don't want to do it. And someday we might be so big that I don't have to. But hey, you know what? We're all just trying to get by in this world, aren't we? And I really enjoy what I do, and I'm sorry if those titles make my content unenjoyable for you. It is what it is. I guess people expect me to apologize for something that I'm clearly doing intentionally, so why would I apologize? All right. I want to address mistakes from this past week. It is something that I wanted to start doing in Friday videos, but I didn't do it yesterday because I kind of just forgot about it. We really only had one mistake from this last week, and this was in regards to talking about the Skyrim Anniversary Edition. I mentioned the only change in it was fishing, and I was corrected by Heavy Metal Riley. He or she said, I need to correct you about the new Skyrim edition a little. You said it only had one new thing, and that is a fishing mechanic. However, that is not all they included in this new edition. They added new dungeons, new quests and missions, new armor and weapons, and so on. So there is more than just a new fishing mechanic added to the Anniversary Edition and package. Yes, some of it is from the Creation Club, aka it's been available already. But it is still new content that was not in the game previously. I would say that for all of those things, would be very nice to have available on the Switch version. Keep up the great work. So they weren't complaining. They were just wanted to make sure that I and others were aware that the Anniversary Edition has additional stuff in it, which makes it all the more disappointing. It's not coming to Switch, at least at this time, despite the announcement that it's going to all platforms. But Switch isn't included, so it's not all platforms. Beyond all that, I wanted to address some questions we took on Discord. The first one comes from Emerald Temple 444. He says, when is the next big channel event? And again, I mentioned it earlier. It's November 28th at 8:30 p.m. Central Time, possibly 8th, but I did 8:30 just to be safe. That's when we have our giveaway, big event question, some tournament stuff. It's going to be a lot of fun there. Our next question came from Electro TDS on Discord as well. It says, here's the question. Will you do more walkthrough live streams? And my answer right now is probably not. If my channel ever gets to a point that I am doing it full time, that is a potential content I'm looking forward to maybe adding. If not full walkthrough content, at least full live stream playthroughs that people might pseudo use as walkthroughs, but that's not their intent. So there is a possibility we might do full live stream playthroughs. It won't be 100%, I don't think, but at least full play streams of them, especially of games that I do launch events for. I think it would be cool to just keep playing it until we beat it. On live stream. So probably not anytime soon, but I mean, at the rate the channel's going, you know, if we end up, you know, full time by the end of next year, which would be a dream, that is a content type I am considering adding with the additional time and effort being put into the channel. Next up, this is some Chinese or Japanese username, and then them, she, hers. I can't read that language, I don't know. It says, I'm a content creator stuck at 74 subs and 10k views. For starters, 10k views is only 74 subs. That's really good, man. Looking to become better at the community part. Like, it's just, I have no clue what does good and what doesn't. I'm trying to figure out what I need to do to make my channel better. That's all. So it's hard to give you specific advice because obviously I haven't reviewed your whole channel. I do know, the channel, based on what you said it was, has a 1 hour introduction. Video, you don't want a 1 hour intro video. If you're gonna do a channel trailer, you want it to be like 1 or 2 minutes at the most. So that's one tip for you, just for people who are brand new to the channel. They're not gonna watch an hour long introduction to your channel. It's too long. Beyond that, don't worry about what does good and what doesn't, especially when you're starting out. Worry about making content that you would want to watch. So when you go on YouTube and you're like, man, what do I want to watch on YouTube? Look for it. And if there isn't a lot of good examples of it, perfect. Time for you to get into that niche and be that example. So that's my number one thing is make content that you want to make, that you're passionate about, that you would also want to watch. Beyond all that, I did listen a little bit to a couple of your videos. I don't know, there's one piece of advice I want to give you, but I'm not sure how easy it will be for you to work on. But it does sound like you mumble a little. If not mumble, just have poor diction and pronunciation, which can make it hard to understand. Now, this could be due to medical conditions. This could be due to several different factors. Maybe English isn't your first language. I'm not in your life to know. But I'm not sure you're even aware. So I want to make you aware that you are a bit hard to understand. What to do about that? That just takes a lot of practice and patience. One thing that used to happen to me a lot in the early YouTube days is I mumbled a lot, because before that, all my experience was written work, where you don't have to worry about diction and pronunciation. Like, you know, when I would say debut instead of debut, right? That was one of my recent mistakes. Like, I didn't worry about how it was said in written work. I just knew how to spell it. It takes some time. So what I ended up doing is I used to be in choir, so I had a voice coach a long time ago, and I just contacted the voice coach and asked for some general advice to make my voice sound more clear when I'm talking. And I think for the most part, a lot of my mumbling, where people don't understand what I am saying, is gone. It still crops up every now and then, and I hear it when I'm editing. But it's something that took me a long time to sort out. Some people just have it naturally. Other people need to work on it. It's a big working on their diction, pronouncing. A big advice I can give you is listen back on your videos before you put them up. And if you hear like a specific word that kind of sounds like it's running together, or it's hard to make out, you know, what that word is, take that word and break it down into small pieces, and then practice each piece of that word individually until you're able to say it all together consistently in a better, you know, a better diction. So it's more understandable. And it could take a long time to get to a point where you're more understandable, because that's gonna help more people wanna watch your videos. But that's the only piece of advice I really have. And again, I'm not sure if there's, you know, extenuating circumstances going on that prevent you from doing it in a more clear, tone and diction, because maybe it's something that just can't be fixed. In that case, hey, just do you and don't worry about it, right? Like, I'm just a guy on the internet. You don't got to listen to me. So Corey asked the following. He said, hey, Nintendo Prime, when will you hire Eric Moore to be a full-time content creator on the channel? And I have some typed out response here, so we'll just read this out. It says, answer, this might be a joke question, knowing you, Corey, but let's address it for real. So absolutely, if and when I can, Eric would be my first hire as another full-time employee of the channel. However, I can't hire him comfortably without first being able to offer him a salary that not only matches what he gets at that time at his other job, but can also offer similar benefits like a 401k, health insurance, benefits, etc. And then even if I don't want to do that, I want to hire him as a full-time contract employee, so I don't have to deal with the headache of that. I have to make sure that I'm compensating him well above what he is paid currently to then cover his own private health insurance and own private retirement fund. So let's just say if it was today that I was trying to hire him, I wouldn't be comfortable hiring him at anything less than 70K a year, just to make sure we have our bases covered. Okay. Like, That's not chump change there. To give you an idea of how far away from that we are, the channel doesn't even make half of that, so pretty far away. So realistically, the channel has to first reach a point where I consider it to be comfortable, which is, you know, less than 70,000 for me. So for the channel to be comfortable for me, it needs to be making about 50 grand a year or so, and that's when I would seriously consider quitting my job. But we'll get there, maybe. Then I have to make the rest of that above and beyond. So realistically, a channel would need to be clearing pretty close to 150,000 a year before I would offer him a full-time position. And obviously I know and offer him a full-time position. I need to get certain commitments from him, like, you know, him committing to learning video editing, him committing to taking some courses on presentation, diction, and, you know, so he could fill in for me for some videos. So I don't always have to be hosting all of the time, especially if I have a lot of business meetings that day, which happen, believe it or not, they've been happening more often than I realized. So yeah, that doesn't mean, by the way, that I don't have other people who already work for the channel. My current MCN actually hired a video editor on my behalf to help us create a channel trailer because we don't have one. And I do have someone who does image work for me that I already pay at the moment. I don't use them for all of my image work, of course, but there might be a day that we do, and we are actually getting pretty close to where I might be using them for most of it. But even then, it's still part-time work. It's not a full-time person on the channel. Then there is the fact that I would like to use a video editor for some of my less time critical pieces, like say a discussion video for the weekend that I might record earlier in the week. But these are all part-time. We're just not close enough to the point where I can bring someone on full-time. Even if I just told them we would stop buying equipment and doing giveaways altogether, and I'll just give them all the money from the channel, it still wouldn't be enough for me to be comfortable hiring anyone. So yeah, it's just more of a, the channel's not there yet. I think, Corey, you obviously know that, and you probably knew this answer, but I wanted to address it because there's a lot of people that always ask me, hey, how can we get Eric on the channel more? And I love that you guys enjoy Eric. He's a really great guy. But it's going to take a lot more to get him there. Plus, he's got to have the interest. He's got to have to want to host videos. He's going to have to want to do video editing. He's going to have to want to learn how to work our camera in a more professional way. He's going to have to want to learn how to use every piece of equipment in the studio. And he's going to have to want to learn how to run this studio on his own if I happen to not be around. Like if I'm on vacation or if I'm, you know, I don't know, just on a trip with my family or at a family reunion or, you know, one of my kids has an event going on, like a basketball game that I'm at, right? Like, you know, he's got to be here to take care of stuff while I'm not. He's got to know the ropes. So there's a lot of, I would love to have him on. And I think in the back of his mind, he would love to work here full time too. There's less pressure on him to do this kind of work than there is at his current job, because you can kind of sort of fudge your own schedule here. But we're a ways away from that. I do have room, by the way, in the studio for a second editing desk, like right here. I have a perfect spot for a second editing rig, so he could edit video while I'm also working on video, and he could do other things as well. Because if I hire him out full time, we are going to relaunch our website, and so he would help manage that as well. So there'd be a lot to work. It's just, yeah, we're not there yet. So. Thank you guys though. That's a long channel update, but again, apparently I only do these once every 3 years. So since I only do them once every 3 years, it of course was going to be rather long. Yeah, this is cool, guys. Some people have been wondering, by the way, where the background music's been coming from. Because we have joined an MCM, we have access again to Epidemic Sound. So a lot of it's just been some lo-fi music we are getting from them. It's not stuff that I can really link you to directly to download because it's a membership only thing. So yeah, that's if you're wondering where I get it from and how I find the music, that's how I find it. Lo-fi is typically the style of music you want to put in the background of videos. There are some exceptions, of course. So yeah, I'm Nathaniel Ruffeljans from Nathaniel Prime, and this was a nice little channel update. Catch you guys on the next one.